The following program is a production of the Fairfax Network, Fairfax County Public Schools.
Doing. This is Innovation Workshop. Nanotechnology is an innovation with big potential, even though it's small in size. So small, it can't be seen with the human eye or even your school's microscope. But this powerful microscope has a different way of seeing things. In fact, it can see and move atoms. You know, those tiny little particles that make up all matter on Earth? I'm at the National Institute for Standards and Technology's Center for Nanoscale Science and Technology. The state-of-the-art equipment at this center enables research, collaboration, and even new discoveries. We'll learn more about this microscope later. First, to understand nanotechnology, you need to understand nanoscale.
Just like inches or feet, a nanometer is a unit of measurement. But you won't find it on any measuring tape. That's because a nanometer is a billion times smaller than a meter. Even a single human hair is bigger than one nanometer. It's actually about 80,000 nanometers.
And nanoscale is hard to kind of wrap your head around. Nanoscale is really small. A nanometer is 1/1,000,000th of a meter. You know, the diameter of the Earth is 8,000 miles. It's called the diameter of the Earth 1 meter. Okay, so then what would a nanometer be? A nanometer would be a marble compared to the diameter of the Earth. That's the difference, the 1/1,000,000th of a meter.
In the metric system, measurements have prefixes. First, let's think about 1 meter. 1 meter is about the length of a baseball bat. Now, let's think smaller. Divide a meter by 10, and you have a decimeter, or a hummingbird. Divide it by 100, and you have a centimeter, or a coffee bean. Watch that decimal point move. Divide it by 1,000 and you have a millimeter, or a single grain of sand. Divide it by 1,000,000 and you have a micrometer, or a dust mite. Finally, divide it by 1,000,000,000 and you have a nanometer. That's a lot of zeros. Human DNA, the flu virus that makes you sick, and molecules are all on the nanoscale. It's hard to imagine a world that's too small to see. From the electronics in your cell phone to the way your nose smells fresh-baked cookies, the nanoscale is a part of our everyday lives.
Scientists and engineers often look to nature. Things that have evolved and work in nature, how do we engineer those properties to enable some sort of functionality? You've ever seen images of the beautiful blue that comes from a morph butterfly? That is because of the texture at the nanoscale that provides that color.
Even the sticky toes of a gecko can inspire other super sticky devices. The nanostructures located on the tiny elastic hairs of their feet are part of the reason that they can climb vertically on almost all surfaces. What would you build if you could mimic this adhesive ability? Biomimicry is a way of mimicking nature to solve problems and create new innovations.
An example of nanotechnology in nature would be the structure that occurs in the lotus leaf. This hierarchical or varying dimensions enables a water droplet to run very quickly off of that leaf. And this structure is being engineered for practical applications. Applications such as stain-resistant clothing. It's also being used for waterproofing, things like your cell phone. So if you drop your cell phone in a puddle, it will protect it. These are applications that are already on the market today.
Nanotechnology involves manipulating and controlling matter from 1 nanometer to 100 nanometers. Just think, even a single sheet of newspaper is 100,000 nanometers thick.
There are so many applications of nanotechnology, and that's actually, it's why I love my job. It's so much fun. So it's not just one thing in one application. It's looking at materials and properties at this size scale, and it really applies to everything. Like coatings for stain resistance or water repellency. Sporting goods is an area, and we've seen a lot of nanotechnology, better bats, tennis rackets, bicycles. So nanotechnology is not just something of the future, it's something that's already here.